Welcome to Woman TV. Today we have a truly interesting and inspirational woman with us, and she is a mompreneur from Delhi, Vaneeta Kumar. Vaneeta is here to share about her Quest Hub's great initiative named as Women on Wheels, Be Bold for Change. This is to help you discover your passion for driving through many fun-filled rides and to enjoy the adventurous treats. I Am Woman is one of its major verticals. Hi Vaneeta.
Hi.
Quite interesting, Women on Wheels. Wow. How did this really begin?
So it started last year, and when everyone comes on the road, you know, you see lots of things happening around, and from there the initiation happened. Why for women this kind of a treatment when they come on the road? Okay, what's the background? What are the research numbers which are talking about? And I think from there I started it off. So I started with Quest Hub, but accidentally Women on Wheels Be Bold for Change happened parallelly. So That's how it started.
So what exactly is this initiative about?
So this initiative is about talking to women, about getting them empowered through women mobility or women commuting cause. So when you look at women empowerment, all this while, over the years, if you see it from policy makers to people like you and me also, have been talking about education and occupation. There is a third factor also for women empowerment, which is women commuting or women mobility. In a simple one sentence, it means a lady should be self-driven, independent when she is traveling from point A to B, rather than calling a male gender of the house saying that mujhe yahan se pick kar lo, mujhe yahan pe drop kar lo. And in fact, if she is aware of the driving also, she doesn't know beyond pedal and steering, most of them. And if the car is stuck or a vehicle is, or even a scooter is stuck, they will just drop it there. They said, we don't know, we are going, manage it yourself. Okay. So these are two things which primarily played a role. Other than that, if you look even onto the statistics, which is very surprising for me when I looked onto it and when we did the research onto that, on an average, it's only 11% of women in India who enjoys the driving license of the total driving licenses available in India. Whereas US and UK numbers are almost close to 50.
Yes.
So it's city to city, yes, it varies. It will go to 30% also. But on an average, 11%, which is very minuscule number.
Yes.
And I think even government is taking an initiative. They have come up with the online driving license also, which is which they claim that it's free of cost for the women. And maybe it's happening in few cities also. But yeah, there's lots more to be done beyond that. This is a behavioral change what we want in a society.
Absolutely.
Okay? And yeah, it doesn't happen overnight.
Yeah.
And if we have taken the initiative, we know this is a long way to go. You know, it will take 3 years, 4 years, maybe 5 years to.
But at least you've taken a step ahead.
But yes, it's a first milestone what we are trying to cross it.
Great.
So this is how it started it all.
Nice. And which are the challenges you face?
So challenges are many. Of course, first, since I said it, it's a behavioral change itself. You know, it's not easy to convince a woman. First of all, if you have convinced her, she is dependent on many other people of the house. So obviously, for us, the target audience is not only a woman. Even the family becomes a target audience to us. You know, why not?
It's all about awareness.
Yeah. And in fact, the stories or the skill partners, what we are having, we are making our content very rich. We are picking skill partners, which means our driving schools, which are by the women itself and for the women. They have been teaching women only, and these are the women who are coming forward and teaching them.
Okay.
So in our entire program, we have certain good things about it. It's not only about driving, which is pedal and steering. It's beyond that, which means enhancing your driving skills.
Yes.
Just to give you a few examples, what it means is, it's like you should know how to change the tire. When you are there at a petrol pump, you should know the front tire and a rear tire, does it really have a difference when you get a air pressure done or not? That's also, you know, most of the people don't know about it.
Yes.
When you switch on the keys, the kind of lights which happen in front of you, the kind of signals which happen in front of you, more than 80% of them are not even aware of that. You are driving in the night, high beam, low beam, what dipper stands for. If you have to climb,
a slope sort of.
Yeah, slopes and all these kind of things. It's never that the, you know, road will be plain, okay, tarmac road, smooth road you will get. You don't even get life like that. Yeah. What hits you, you don't know. You will come to know there and then. So these are the things which we are talking about. We are talking about when your car is heated and you know coolant is not there. First, you should know where the coolant is and how to check the coolant, whether it's there or not. What is the Indian Jugadu way to, you know, get the thing?
So these are all important factors.
Yeah, important
which are...
factors. How to check the engine oil. Then a couple of months back, you are aware of that that one of the RJs, she lost her life because her car sinked. And the primary reason was her car got, because of anti-locking system, car got locked. She didn't know how to break the glass. She didn't know how to cut the seat belt.
Yes.
So, you know, these kind of things usually don't come, they don't just come, it just happens to you. And that point in time, no Google will help you, you know.
Right.
You really need to struggle with that situation there and then. So these are the things what we talk about, enhancing driving skills.
Good.
And which one should be aware of it. It's good, you don't need in a life, it's really nice, but any point
what if
that,
you need it?
Yeah, what if you need it?
Right.
And there's something called first aid of a vehicle. So please don't Google that, that's not the term which exists. That's formed by us only, so there is no point Googling that.
But they can get in touch with you to know more.
So that's it, we are Google for that. So it's all about, as you have a first aid box, similarly there is a first aid of a vehicle. You should know those basics of vehicle. There is a possibility you may require that, there is a possibility you may not. You're fortunate enough you don't require it, but there are times when it's required.
That's great.
So this is what we talk about, enhancing driving skills. So our skill partner not only teaches the ladies who wants to learn driving from scratch, but they also help in enhancing their driving skills. Other than that, there are friends which come, they have lost the confidence in driving, and they lost confidence not because they were not confident, because they were told so much ki tumse nahi ho payega, why you are getting on the onto the road. And on roadside also the kind of things happen, we all know it. When a lady is driving, it's not easy to struggle on the road too.
Okay.
So obviously there are ladies which give up also, or they have taken a sabbatical and that's the reason they have given up. So just to bring them back into that motion, that also we help it. And the third is, yes, if you know the driving, it's good to impart those skills to other ladies, and that's how we take it forward. Because if a woman doesn't help a woman, then there is no point. I mean, I don't know who will help us.
And in Pune, you have Pula as your associate, which is Pune Ladies Group, the biggest group of Facebook in Pune. So how is it? How's the response? And I'm sure that it's very helpful.
So, amazing, amazing group to associate with and collaborate with. Hats off to the founders.
Sonia.
Really hats off to you. How you are managing it, you only know that. I can't even think of it doing that way. But at the same time, the kind of response also what we are getting is very enthusiastic. I mean, Pune has that warmth, you know.
Yes.
And they are very upcoming ladies. They want to try new things. And so I think I'm at a really good place to even initiate the project and take it forward from there. And whosoever I'm interacting with, I'm just loving the conversation. The only drawback which I see in myself is I don't know Marathi, so I need to learn Marathi.
Oh.
I think over a period of time I'll pick a few things and I'll be able to communicate with you guys much.
We aren't English anyway. Right.
So this is how it is.
Nice. And they're coming towards the end. What's that inspiring message you would like to give across to the women watching you?
I have two messages, frankly. First is, no one will teach you confidence. If you are not confident, no one can make you confident. So you need to believe in yourself. If you believe in yourself, you can do everything and whatever you feel like doing it. So that's my first message to them. And as far as women empowerment, so-called, is concerned, our research and thorough research of almost like 9 to 10 months says is that women empowerment doesn't happen in isolation.
Yes.
It can't be only education, it can't be only occupation, it can't be only financial security, it can't be only women mobility or commuting. And if you see, all is interlinked. If you are educated, there is an occupation, what you have it. If you have an occupation, you are financially secured. And if you are financially secured and you need to run your business or you are into a job also, you need to step out of the house. To step out of the house, you need to be independent and self-driven. So I think there we complete the cycle.
That's great.
So, yeah.
So that was Vaneeta Kumar, the proud founder of the concept Women on Wheels. Stay tuned for more updates on the same. Thank you from Women TV.